intimidation, if you like, that they've prepared simultaneously. No, indeed, the Samoans waiting for the Thimbi, led by Joely Vaitiaki. Joely out there, as he did so well in South Africa. The big, massive body of the King Country prop, who played in the Super 12. And there it is, the Thimbi. And now the Western Samoa swings straight into action. Vatialofa, and it looks like to Uvaenga in the leading position. And Vatialofa, said to be leading the Samoans for the last occasion, is out there. He was given the accorded the privilege of being able to enter the ground before any of the other players. And here we have it, yes, Tuku Vaenga was out there as the other leader of the game and other leader of their war dance. And we wait now for the start of it to see the commencement of our game, Western Samoa versus Fiji, in the series 1996. Waiting then, and it's Fiji to kick off. And as we saw in South Africa, it looks like Sarevi is going to be the man who will set the game in motion for Fiji, taking the kicks from halfway and at the 22. And here we have Sarevi taking the southern end of the ground at the centre field. The referee, black jersey, Samoa in their blue, Fiji in their white jerseys, Sarevi with hand up, so too Paddy O'Brien. And there is the opening kick from Sarevi, and straight into it as the Samoans battle it backwards, taken back there by Pat Lamb in defence to start with, and the Fiji forwards pour through on top, and they're hunting for the ball, no sign of it coming out, and as Fiji takes the first scrum of the encounter with the non-emergence of the ball. It was held in there by Samoa, they didn't use it, and Paddy O'Brien has offered it to Fiji 5 metres inside the 22, that's the 15 metre line from the grandstand side of the field, and this will be Sekofi Raluni to put it in for Fiji. In it goes, and hooked and held, Dan Rouse just holding it, controlling it at the back, Rowling, he gets it and gets it away to Nicky Little. Nicky gets a double around and across, a double out wide, and good movement and out to Sarevi and onto the wing, and there goes 2-11, 2-11, and they haven't gone 1 minute. A beautiful piece of play, and the Samoans split aside right at the very beginning. Wonderful handling, and it was the movement across by Sarevi. Sarevi making the space, and his double, and the decoy, Sale Saravaki on the outside, Nicky Little moving it straight across, and Fiji in the corner. I see a Tuilevi taking it. He had no room to move in, and did it so cleanly, and within a minute, Fiji leading Samoa by 5-0. That brings back the Samoans on their part to have a chat. And here's Nicky Little, a metre outside the 22, a metre in from the sideline. And Isia Tuilevu, one up to Fiji, as we wait now for Nicky Little, very close to the sideline. There's not a breeze here on the National Stadium. It'll be all on his own metal. They're looking at it very carefully, but they turn it away. Fiji in the lead by 5-0. What a wonderful run. Nice piece of work. The decoy was there. The Samoans took the decoy, provided the space for Sarevi coming in wide from the fullback berth, and as he did so, cleared it wide, and it was finished off brilliantly by 2-11. Here we have now, and bye-bye, puts a long kick, taken by Smith. He's got room to work his way forward. Up he went, 10 metres outside the 22. Stand back, Samoa, said the referee, and Sarevi clears it towards the grandstand sideline. Driving Samoa back, an awkward kick. Will it get towards the touchline? Doesn't reach it. It's there to Massino. He's caught in possession, though. He's got support, manages to clear it away to Uvaenga. He sends a lob pass right across into the centre. It's a dangerous one, but infield then comes there, Pepe. He's caught and taken to the ground midway, 22 and halfway. Down on the ground it is, and Fiji's rummaging around it. No sign of it for the moment, and out it comes on the Samoan side. And here's Vavai, puts a long kick in, Sarevi coming across to cut it off, and slips to the ground, unable to cut it, and the ball into touch on the 22, goes back and recovers it himself, a long kick down there, Manasseh Mbari clears it back into touch, and the ball into touch, about 5 metres inside the Fiji half, on this grandstand sideline, and some good combination between Manasseh Mbari, short of that ball, getting into touch, and certainly took the pressure off the Fiji line by his having done so. Andy O'Brien calling for the space down the centre of the line. As the Samoans curve away towards their side, at the front for Fiji, at number one jumper, number one right at the very front, is Amori Katilau. And high one and up high, Western Samoa have got a clear filly move. On it goes that time to Leo Pepe up over the halfway line. He didn't cross his own advantage line, taken to the ground, picked up then by Sokovi. Sokovi onto Lawrence Little, not to Lawrence, to Nicky Little. Down there goes 2-11, 2-11 going right for the corner. And a hurried race across there by Farmacino. Just managed to clear it into touch ahead of a flying Nandrangard 2-11. And Tuilevu actually speeding down that sideline. One gave him no chance to have got up as far as he did. And Samoa back on their own goal line again, right in the corner. Fiji on the attack, and it's Smith to throw in near the front. A difficult take for Fiji. Let's put it in again, said the referee. He wasn't satisfied they were ready for the line-out. And it'll go in once again. That'll be Smith once again to put it into the line-out for Fiji. And an interesting one. One notes just how tall the Samoans are. They've found tall men, and that's made a huge difference to the Samoan side. As in it comes into the line, up high, Katilau gets it, and they go around the front, and a brilliant try. And around the front, Mark Black. Black got it, a beautiful one, a tap down near the front of the line, and Mark Black is the man who did it for Fiji. And he did it. His army had time to raise his arm up high and slam it to the ground with joy. And Black, the man who got that try, what a brilliant one from the front of the line, from a controlled take by Katilau, and a nice piece of play at the front of that line-out has given Fiji the advantage of 10 points to nil. Nicky Little, a kick from pretty near the same position as where the last one was, a metre outside the 22, a metre in from the terrace side of the field, in front of that packed terrace behind. And we wait for Nicky Little to see if he can improve upon his last effort. Two tries, play gone, 5 minutes. Nicky Little lifts it this time, they're watching it carefully, they still flag it away, and it remains at 10 to nil. 5 minutes into the game, and Fiji have blown Western Samoa's attempts out right at the very start of this game. The huge crowd at the back thrilled at the effort of Fiji in their lead over Western Samoa soon after the start. Again, a long kick from Fa'avai. It was a wrong kick from him, it was said. And goes to Serevi. Serevi clears it towards touch. He doesn't find it into touch. A little bit of misunderstanding. That time Brian Lima puts a long kick in. It's allowed to go back towards the goal line. And back there, shadowing it over the goal, is Serevi. Serevi playing with him, knowing he's had time. And Brian Lima was forcing Serevi to touch. A dropout 22. Serevi brings it into the centre of field. And we wait for Serevi to set it alight again. 6 minutes gone. Fiji 10, Western Samoa 0. And there is an unusual one, a deep one right down towards the 22. Taken back there. Farmacino comes up to the 10-meter line. A little chip kick over the top. It's taken in there by Tomini Valu. He swivels like the top to the ground. Sets it up nicely. Sokovi gets it. Gets it out onto the open side. A difficult one across there. Nicky wasn't giving it neatly. Across to Manasa Mbari. But knocked forward, said the referee, when Manasa went to pick it up first time. And back we come for the scrum. The scrum to go down 4 metres inside Fiji's territory and 15 in from the grandstand sideline. This will be halfback Joe Folimu to put it in. Samoa have got it hooked. It's held at the back and onto the short side, and an attack down there by Rouse. Rouse goes up after it and hesitates just the moment, but Vanessa Mbari's up there, increases the pressure upon the Samoan defence, and a race through there. A good effort from Dan Rouse, who managed to knock the pass down, charge it down, and Samoa back on their heels again after they've won that scrum. 10 metres inside the 22, grandstand side of the field, and it's Greg Smith to put the ball in. Speaking to the referee, and a little problem there. We notice at the front of Pele Naituivau at the front for Fiji. Pele, then Katalau at number two. Back at three is Joelli. Four is Efrem Mitawaki. Dan behind him. And Dan lifts it's Tawaki. And taken in by Sokovi. He goes and gives it straight out to Sarli. Sarli Sarawaki dodging. He's 10 metres out from the line. Ball lost to the ground. And lost forward there, said the referee by Fiji. A nice break by Sarli Sarawaki. And Sarli was just crowded as he himself probably tripped to the ground and lost the ball forward. And it's a Western Samoa put in defensively 10 metres out from the goal line. It'll be Filimu to put it in. He's got it in and it's overrun. And ball comes to the ground and scrambled up by Fiji and then another try. No, the referee said too many hands on the ball. It was actually the ball that actually bounded off the post, the base of the post there. It was in no man's land and it became a free ball for Fiji to dive upon. And here we've got Fiji in a wonderful attacking position. I notice Mbari going onto the short side. In it comes. And they go across to cover it, though. And offside, coming around too quickly. And attacking Fiji was Western Samoa. Sokovi went to gather that ball. They were surrounding him. And the penalty. And it will be a penalty shot at goal from straight in front. Fiji intent to make certain that they get points on the board against a Samoan side that at the moment is a little bit upset. They're obviously not found their gait, and at this stage it's Fiji with great strength. That try at the opening, and now the first penalty to Nicky. The penalty scored in the ninth minute of play. 9 minutes, and Fiji ahead by 13 points to nil. Penalty to Nicky. And so it's Fiji in the three opening scoring movements of the game so far. And there's another kick from Vaivai. He's intent to put it into the centre field. Taken by Sarevi. Waste no time. Clears it back towards the grandstand sideline. And the ball bounds into touch. A high bouncing ball. And it finds touch 12 metres inside the Samoan territory. The game, all the game so far in the 10 minutes of it, has been played in Samoan ground with only the kickoffs entering Fiji's space. Leasa to put the ball in for Western Samoa. In it goes and up high, but it's tapped back neatly, nicely done there from Sene. And on wide to Vainga, but he runs into trouble. They've got him and pulled him to the ground. Fiji surrounding it, and it's a penalty against Fiji. Held ball in there, said the referee. We'll have the penalty to Western Samoa, with Fiji asked to go back 10 metres, and that is the description, the new rule given to us by Paddy O'Brien. The defenders must be back 10 metres, must continue back 10 metres before they can enter the game again. Into touch. 8 metres inside Fiji's territory on the terrace side of the field. With it will be Samoa's Leasa to put the ball in. Big gap down the centre there. Katalau at number two in the line. And it comes again and up high. It was a big jump from Stephen Smith. He wasn't able to get it cleanly, but eventually Samoa tidy it up. Through they go, but then more trouble there is for them. And back in goes the Western Samoans. Neatly done in the Onehunga. Down onto the ground, back the other direction. Taken away there by Pat Lam. He got it alive and puts a kick into touch. And the penalty against Fiji. A penalty against Fiji. Offside, said the referee. The penalty awarded 5 metres inside Fiji's territory and near to centre field. What some are going to do with it, with the penalty offered to them, 12 minutes into the first half, and it looks as if it's going to be an attempt at goal for Avaye. Vaivai is to take the shot from almost level with the left hand upright and 5 metres inside Fiji's territory. For those who've just joined us, it was an explosive try within a minute of the opening of the game, where I see a Tuilevu finished a backline movement for Fiji. Then there was a movement from the front of the lineout while Fiji were hard on attack, Black collecting the score. And the third was a penalty from Nicky Little in the ninth minute. And that took it on 13 points to nil. We've now gone 13 minutes, a point a minute so far, with Western Samoa, their first opportunity to score. High ball and a long ball. It looks a good one. It was a good strike. It's outside the left-hand upright. Nobody touching it. A dropout 22, says referee Paddy O'Brien. We'll wait for the restart of play. Serevi to do so. And Serevi already got the Samoans watching as to where he's going to put it. And again, it's a long kick. Way back 10 metres outside the 22 to Uvainga. Uvai puts a long kick and drives them back again. And the ball bit the ground and across it went, almost at right angles to its flight. And into touch, 4 metres inside the 22 on that terrace sideline. Samoa, their closest to attack so far in the game, 4 metres inside Fiji's 22. Smith waiting for the call to get the advice of what his backs are going to do. See a little reorganisation in the backs of Fiji as Smith to throw into there again and cut allow at 2. And we've got Efereimi in at 4. Behind him, Rouse ready to give him a helping hand. And back it goes, taken by Cutelo. Takes it in this time. Held in there nicely. And Fiji driving on the Samoans, rolling it towards the centre field. They're continuing to progress forward and puts the Samoans quite a way back. And Raului working his forwards well. They've gone over the 22-metre line and actually walking the Samoans back. Around the side goes Apele Naituibau. They've gone to the ground. The Samoans smother the ball. And the referee has said it is a Fiji put-in. Some grand work in the forward line there by Apele Naituibau, taking them all with him as he burst away from the side of it and made progress up to almost midway 22 and halfway in Fiji territory. Raluni to put it in. Held up at the feet. Raluni gets it away out onto the open. A nice one to Nicky. And there Saleh puts a long kick in this time. A long one angled towards the touchline. And again, driving Western Samoa back. The ball finding touch 5 metres outside the 22. And the ball out in front of Massino. He covered it well but couldn't cut it off. And there was no option but to see the ball spin into touch on this grandstand sideline. 13 points to nil, 15 minutes gone. Leasa to put the ball in for Western Samoa. In it goes. And there was a little bit of mistiming there. Western Samoa finally getting it. Trying to work around toward it as Amori Katalau couldn't get it. Back it goes. The surprise that coming back to Onahanga. He burst his way through. Good tackle upon him by Dan Rouse. He's pulled him to the ground midway 22 and halfway. Western Samoa right up there. They've got it again. Through goes Smith. Smith caught and pulled to the ground again. He's held down onto the ground. Back it goes again to Western Samoa. Out wide they swing it quickly. And there's a bit of a gap in there. But not able to get through Leo Pepe. Across they go once again. And down the sideline. A grubber kick through from Talia. Right back there is Serevi. He turns it back, clips it towards touch and doesn't find it. But Massino brings it out into the centre. They bring their attack from there to Uvainga. There's Onahanga once again. He goes forward, gives it on to Brian Lima. He goes in amongst the forwards and can't go anywhere in court. Pulled to the ground, scrambled away then by Pets Perialova. And across it comes once again. Onahanga featured on the grandstand sideline. He tried to push off half the Fiji team and was taken to the ground. Back up to Samoa again. Brian Lima caught to the ground. He's caught on the outside the 22. Western Samoa settled down. Back out wide it goes. Across the other side to Uvainga. He's taken the wrong option and couldn't get rid of the ball. Taken to the ground. And a good tackle upon him by Saleh Sorabaki. Bundled him up. And to Uvainga. But there's nowhere to go. As Saleh Sorabaki smothered him with a wonderful tackle, pulled him to the ground just outside that 22, and down they went. Western Samoa to put it in nevertheless, and this will be for Lemu to put it in for Western Samoa, 10 outside the 22, close to centre field, an ideal platform to attack from. They opt to go onto the short side. They've got an extra man there, and across they go. They've across the sideline and too slow to clear the ball. A man on the wing was left wide open. They didn't get the ball away. They're going down the sideline as Senni. Senni then forced into touch some 4 metres from the corner flag, but the Samoan forwards coming back strong. A great period of possession there by the Samoans as they rucked, moved it, rucked again, moved it back, and mauled the ball back into their backs for 3 or 4 separate occasions. Smith to put it in defence for Fiji. Standing back deeper this time is Tawaki, I see. Gone back to number five. Smith's to put it in, deep down. Behind him, Tamanivalu. Waiting, in it comes, and Katalau puts it down. Didn't get it cleanly, though. The ball, the advantage to Western Samoa. Referee said Katalau knocked it forward. We take the scrum. And this, a defensive scrum from Fiji. And this, I imagine, will be an attempted pushover from Western Samoa. Fiji have had the experience in South Africa of holding the pressure forced upon them in such occasions. We'll see how they stand up to it. Vilimu puts it in. Now he's deciding to clear it away. Has a run on his own. Feeds it back in. And a good effort from Western Samoa. They set it up once again. An effort close to the post. Now he's bundled away from there. Western Samoa not able. But here they come once again. Fadi Alofa goes through. And they claim a try, but the referee had said he had knocked it forward as he went together. And a good, determined effort from Fadiello for that time, but he was unable to reach the line and fumbled forward as he adjusted the ball. Sokovia Raoulou needs to put it in for Fiji. And it's held there. Raoulou goes himself. Puts a long kick towards touch on that terrace sideline and finds it into touch. Into touch, 7 metres inside his own half. An enormous kick from right inside his own goal area. And he wasted no time to think that he was going to do it himself and save the pressure upon his supports. Great work from Raoulouni, a very plucky halfback, a man who played mightily in South Africa, one whose work rate takes a lot of beating. So we wait now again for Liasa to put it in. Then it comes into the line down near the back, and a great take there from Sini Taala. Onto the ground it is for Western Samoa. They've got it out. An angled kick across towards the grandstand sideline, and it bounces kindly for them. Not into touch. Taken by Serevi instead, and Serevi wasting no time. He in turn drives it towards touch. Fumbled and taken by Massino. He goes forward there, decides he's going to run with the ball. Smith decides he's not. Down onto the ground they go, 5 metres outside the 22. Back out comes Western Samoa. Can't get it. A tremendous effort. Dan Rouse right up over the top of the ball. Spoiled Western Samoa's attempted drive forward. And we've got a scrum to Fiji. 15 outside the 22 and 7 or 8 in from the grandstand sideline. And a bit of misunderstanding and a little bit of disagreement in there as referee Paddy O'Brien says, Western Samoa, slow it down, tidy it up. The referee calls in Joely Vaitiaki, and indeed, black. Some words being said, and the penalty to Samoa. And that was, I believe, from the after play rather than the foreplay. And here's Western Samoa's for Massino, and to see whether he can put points on the board for Western Samoa. Play in progress now, 22 minutes. 22 minutes gone. Fiji hold the early lead of 13 points to nil, and for Massino attempting to narrow the gap. For Massino's kick from 14 metres outside the 22, and 8 in from the grandstand sideline. There's the angle you saw. Famasino. Been unsuccessful with his only effort earlier. A left footer moving wide. And with not a movement in the trees behind, you can see how still the atmosphere is. Massino moves forward. And he's hooked it well away, well outside the right-hand upright. And he really slugged at that one. And a very bad strike. The score remaining at 13 points to nil. 23 minutes gone in the first half. Fiji leading Western Samoa in the Tri-Nation Series. And Serevi again, a huge kick. A long one for Massino. Knocks the ball forward as he goes to take it. Banasram Bari right up there. Runs into Smith. Smith shoulder charges him down. And Massino not only disappointed from losing the ball, but disappointing also for losing his feet as he ran into a dogged Smith. The scrum to go down. Sokobi, and off goes Dan Rouse. He's turned over, he manages to leave the ball behind. Sokobi gets it up, across to Nicky Little, and across it goes to Saleh. Saleh's held and pulled to the ground there. Leo Pepe holding on to him, taken to the ground, five outside the 22. Out it comes to Fiji. Nicky again, gets it across left, and here is Tamani Valu. He runs into a tackle, turns it over nicely, and back out it comes to Sokobi. Our bouncing pass, taken by Sarevi. Sarevi gets it quick across to Tuilevu, and Tuilevu, a little chip kick. He chips it, and the ball races up there. The ball tapped into touch, on defence by Western Samoa. A free kick to Fiji. 5 metres out from the goal line, 15 in from touch. The free kick from the tap into touch by Western Samoa. And they're going to take a tap and run by the look of it. The forwards go lining up, the Fiji forwards. Are they going to do it? Or are they going to have it? No, they can't have a shot at goal, of course. A tap it's got to be. And the Fiji forwards lined up. There they go. And drive straight in. Smith backs his way as he turns, and the Fiji forward over the line. And a try. A try to Fiji. With who's coming up with the ball? And there was Katalau came up with the ball. A try to Katalau. That was made to look so easy. Katalau's try scored in the 25th minute. 25 minutes from the start, and Maury Katalau, he got it, must have taken it from Smith. Smith gathered it, and Smith, I think, was the architect of that. The way in which he took the ball, and as he took it, he spun. And he went away from the force of the defence, and the gap must have been there for Katalau, who was forced over the might of the Fiji bunch of forwards, and takes it on to 18 points to nil. The try scored 9 metres in from the terrace side of the field. 25 minutes and 18 points scored. Nicky Little a chance to add to that and make it 20 points scored. The Fiji forwards having a very understanding combination, and that's been the telling tale so far. Western Samoa have only had 4 or 5 minutes of control in these first 25. Nicky tries again, and this time raises the flag. There's 20 points to nil. The huge, biased Fiji crowd delighted with the effort. And Nicky's conversion. These, of course, are the first kicks, if I can recollect. Yes, I think these are the first kicks that Nicky has shown on Fiji territory. Nicky having been so successful in the Ballymore Tens, successful in South Africa, and oh, how much we regret he wasn't with us in Wales. Taken by Smith, 5 outside the 22, 10 in from the terrace touchline. Tchaikovsky's got it, gets it straight back, the referee's whistle's gone. A Western Samoa put in, he said. He considered the ball wasn't used, and so we put it in. It'll be a Western Samoa put in from Filimu. Western Samoa put in, they've got it. Off the back comes Pat Lamb. He goes as far as he could, taps it back, and Filimu got it. He was able to flick it away, but it was a tap back. Ball gone loose. In comes, this time, is Nanyal. He couldn't get it, though. Sokobi trying to get it. Western Samoa blocking Sokobi from getting it. Eventually he gets it straight back to Sarevi. Sarevi drives it at an angle once again, crossed towards the grandstand sideline. Manassem Bari racing up like a train and leaving for Messina with very little option but to drive it into touch as well. And that's the first time we've seen Manassem Bari with an opportunity to show the speed that he's got and the pressure that he created on for Messina. Had him hastily left-footing it into touch, finding it in touch, right on the 22-metre line. Manassem Bari in the 11 jersey there was tramping as he went along, and both wings, Bari and Isaiah Tuilevu, showing speed in front of the home crowd that the 30,000 would be pleased with. Smith. Into the line it goes, right down the back, and a nice take by Tamani Valu at the back. He's got it positioned. Western Samoa roll over the top of the ball. And as they smothered the ball there, referee was right there, was Paddy O'Brien. And he was able to direct the placement into the scrum. Fiji. Good work from Tamani Valu. Sokobi puts it in for Fiji. And a flick away down the grandstand sideline. A dash away along that sideline. Onto his feet again. Rolini, and he a penalty against the Samoans, a high tackle, and that was Sir Kobe Rauluni. It was just a flick off the side, straight into the waiting hands there of Rauluni, and he was away down the sideline, if anything, lacked any support. Joelle says, we'll slow it down, and from the penalty, it'll be an opportunity for Nicky to add to his present tally of one conversion and one penalty. Fiji already successful with three tries. Western Samoa have yet to reach Fiji's scoreline. So Nicky Little has this, and he's positioned right on the 22-metre line, the intersection of it, with the 5-metre line, as we see the huge crowd behind. Nicky Little, a very tidy right-footer, had experience right through New Zealand schoolboy rugby, was chosen in the New Zealand Colts team, and opted to play for Fiji. Nicky Little moves forward. And a very gentle tap, he steered it well. He actually controlled it all the way, almost as if by remote, and Nicky Little extends Fiji's lead to 23 points to nil with a penalty. That penalty now in the 30th minute. Well, an interesting one at 15 points to 11, the All Blacks defeating the South Africans, and it's here Fiji leading the Western Samoans by 23 points to nil. We're waiting for it to come up to Fiji, and it comes onto the open side. Down the grandstand sideline comes Nicky Little. He's gone through the gap. He's got a Maury on the inside, and Maury flicks it back. It's picked up by Fadialofa instead, and Samoans on defence. The quick attack of Fiji downs them to the ground. Back out it comes, playing halfback with Smith, across to Sarevi, across it goes again, and there goes Ekwuribi Tawaki, and Tawaki crosses the line and comes around underneath the post. Well, the Samoans are absolutely devastated at that. There were very few across on the terrace sideline. They were all expecting it to come out onto the open, and Fiji, so many men in the back line, they had to move the ball quickly because they were being crowded, and across it went to Ifiremi, and Ifiremi bolted away from the defence. He had men sitting outside him. He crossed the line midway, corner flag and upright, and then came round into the middle, and Ifiremi then has taken it on to 28 points to nil. Nicky Little with a chance to make it 30 from straight in front. Samoans standing behind, devastated, 30 points to nil. Who would have expected this? Play gone now 31 minutes, and in 31 minutes, it's Fiji 30, almost a point a minute in this first half, with Nicky getting the conversion, his second, and Ifiremi logging up Fiji's fourth try. A performance you couldn't expect, but a performance that reflects the effort that Fiji put in against the Springboks. And against the Springboks, they were equally devastating. The amount of ball that was won by Fiji and South Africa had to be seen to be believed, as we have the long kick for a bye-bye. My ball, says Smith, goes up and takes it. He takes the battering of the Blues as they came in upon him as well. And out it comes Sokovi again. Sokovi to Nicky. Nicky, and out it comes to Sarevi. Sarevi towards the grandstand sideline. He's angled it well and beats them all. Brian Lever couldn't get his fingertips to it. And a drive into touch. The effort is obvious that Fiji say we'll play the game in Western Samoa's territory. And I'm certain that they were told they don't want any ball inside their own half. That's the way it appears to be. And the angled kicks from Sarevi continuing to drive the Samoans back. The contact in the forwards, not nearly as much as we might have expected as Fiji clear it. Up high, a bad time jump from them, but it's taken nicely by Cartelau, by Black down at the back there. Out it comes, and Smith runs into trouble. He sets it up, however, back behind, and taking it instead is Cartelau. Cartelau goes forward. He's cut down like a log in the forest. And back it comes Sokovi again. Sokovi goes straight out into Tamanivalu. He roars his way forward there and decided to take it into fourth phase play. And back out it comes once again now. is waiting to bring it out that time. Was a Pelinei Tuivalu. The referee said, you don't need to. We'll take the scrum. We'll take the scrum from in front. But 8 metres outside the 22, a Fiji put in, and it'll be Sekofi Rauluni to do so. In it goes, and back it comes to Dan Rouse, and might have thought Samoa was offside, as out it goes Manasseh Bari, and a lovely little one from Sarevi. Ball not connected as Bari went around the outside of him, but obstruction, said the referee. It was obstruction, pushing of the Fiji team as they attempted to come through that gap. Sarevi and Bari playing it together like brothers, and it is another attempt to increase Fiji's tally, 30 already, and from 8 metres outside the 22 and 12 in from the terrace side of the field, it's Fiji with an opportunity in the 34th minute to see if they can increase the score. That was some excellent understanding, and that's just exactly the point of Fiji's play, the understanding that the players have amongst themselves. We wait now for Nicky. Nicky, who steered it nicely from this grandstand sideline, now trying it from the terrace sideline. Here it goes, and Nicky has driven it between the posts, 33 points to nil. And that would log up Nicky's third penalty. With play gone now 35 minutes, it's 33 points to nil. Almost a point a minute to Fiji in the first half. Remember, the whole game in South Africa was a point a minute for the whole game for two sides. At this rate, it's Fiji showing a point a minute in this first half. Taken by Catalau, goes forward, turns it round. Now was Ifirimi. He's gone forward and down onto the ground he goes. Referee looking at it carefully, and out to Nicky. Nicky's left-footed, driving him back once again across an angle kick, and it bounces brilliantly. A beautiful position kick from Nicky Little off his left that time, and the ball bounced 3 metres inside the field of play and ran away as Grant Fox is always used to. And so Paddy O'Brien right up there, the game played in great spirit so far. Fiji getting a wealth of ball, and that is the telling tale to Samoa. We wait now for Tala Leasa to put the ball into this line from 5 metres outside his 22. Ready for it, and up high was Catalau, tussled for it, ball went loose, Smith went in on the wrong side, I might have thought. The advantage to Western Samoa, they've got it straight back to 5-8, puts a long kick in, Manasseh Bari waits for it, he's got it, goes forward up to the 10, and the referee had said, we'll have the penalty. A penalty, let me think what it was we noticed there. He takes them back for the penalty at the last phase of play. Bye-bye has a kick. He doesn't get it as far as he did before, but they get the position, of course, from the line-out. The line-out where they'll throw it in some 7 metres inside Western Samoa's territory on the grandstand side of the field. Fiji ahead, 33 points to nil. Again, Western Samoa to put it in. Tala Leasa. And I see Amori going right to the very front of the line this time, and he's hoisted up. Ifirimi gets it. Ifirimi gets it, but it's a difficult one. Smith has to gather and slides into touch, almost like the soccer players do. Tidied it up. Smith, always a very muddied player, reflective upon the tremendous amount of work that he does in both attack and defence. Talara again for Western Samoa. Up high was Western Samoa. Jumping through there, neatly done, was Black. He's got it at the back of the back of the mall, and Fiji have got it held in there as Western Samoa drive in upon them. A big effort from Samoa. They're rolling the mall and Fiji backwards. Inside Fiji's territory now. They keep Samoa keeping it, working it. And Emori trying to get over the top of that maul as Western Samoa drive in field, and Fadialofa taken to the ground. And away they've got it. Western Samoa got it out amongst their backs. A long angled kick this time. Ball goes back. Tuilevu's got it. inside his 22. No risk, no time waste. And Tuilevu from inside his 22 sits them back on their heels. Drives it into touch, finding touch 9 metres inside his own half. The ball seemed to go such a long way into Western Samoa's territory, but much of it was certainly in touch. So the line-out takes place on the 10-metre line in Fiji territory on that terrace sideline. And it comes into the line and up high once again. Efraimi not able to get his fingertips to it that time. Samoa took it in well. And out they've got it, out onto the open. And across it comes there, Pepe. He's caught, though. He can't get rid of it. It was actually on a hunger with him. Tried to support. Back out it comes. Picked up nicely. In through there goes Black. And with him was Emory. They continue the attack forward. Fiji's forwards, and across it goes. Across onto the short side. Nicky's weaving his way through. He gave it upfield to Tuilevu. Back it comes to Smith. Knocked forward there. And Fiji backs just managed to get into position in time, and Nicky tramped around that short side and really was wanting for support. The call was on the outside, the pass came on the inside. Smith found it difficult to gather, but a lot of ground gained by Fiji. 4 metres outside the 22. The scrum to go down, and half-time looming on our clock here as we wait for Filiamu to put it in for Western Samoa. Referee talking to the front row. And not very happy, the ball not going in and the scrum's collapsing to the ground. It's perhaps a little fatigue taking its position now. And I notice Brendan Reedy having his say on the ground on the far side for Western Samoa. They get up once again and Tala assumes his position in the centre for Western Samoa. In it goes and he's got it raked well. Fiji turning it round, but back out it comes wide. Western Samoa opting to play it the same way Fiji is. A high ball, bounces towards the ground. It actually bounced backwards and into touch on the grandstand sideline. Ball well covered by both Manasseh Mbari and Wesley Zarevi on this grandstand sideline. They didn't have to touch it as the ball bounded directly into touch from the first bounce. There we are. I was just looking at the clock and thinking it's just on half-time. Half-time it is. And Fiji lead Western Samoa by 33 points to nil. And for almost the entire duration, it was a point for a point. Only these last few minutes have Western Samoa won enough ball to stem the flow of Fiji attack. Here, referee O'Brien says, get it moving. And there's the long one, taken by Sokovi. A reverse pass back there to Nicky Little. And a very gentle tap into touch, steered beautifully again from Nicky Little. And into touch, it's gone. Pat Lamb just helping the line umpire by saying, well, there it went out. And the line out to take place. And it's Western Samoa's Talal Nasa. Put it into the line. Of visitors from Samoa. And interesting to notice that the very front of the line of Fiji is Dan Rouse guiding and guarding Emory Katalau behind. And at number three is Efraimi. And a long pass tapped back there by Samoa. They couldn't combine. Noanahanga couldn't get his ball away. It's taken by Pat Lamb trying to tidy it up for Western Samoa. But knocked through, said the referee, by Fiji as they kept marching the Samoans backwards. The scrum just inside Fiji's territory by 4 metres. It'll be halfback Joe Filiamu to put the ball in, and a very quick, hurried hook, and straight out it goes. Caught back there is Pat Lamb. He's playing there as an extra 5-8, and a penalty against Fiji over the top, taken quickly there by Western Samoa. They lacked the support, not everybody ready for it. Onahunga was there going forward with them, and trying to go through with it as Reedy. Ball lost to the ground, lost, left behind. And a knock forward by Western Samoa. They're trying to do things just a bit hurriedly at the start of the second half and haven't found their feet yet. So we wait for it to go into the scrum once again. This time it'll be Sokovi Rauluni to put it in for Fiji.
in it, guys, and Dan Rouse got it held for Sekovi and Samoa. Sekovi decides he'll have a run on his own and angles a grubber kick towards the grandstand sideline as he found Phil Emu coming around on the other side for him, which really and effectively cut off the link that he might have had with his backs on the open side. Intelligent and wise play from Rauluni there as he takes Fiji into Samoa's territory, 12 metres. Western Samoa to put it in. 12 into the Western Samoan territory. No change in the second half so far. And then it goes up high and ball tapped down to the ground, taken by Apelli, who ties his up neatly. And back it comes to Rauluni. On it goes to Tamanivalu. He rushes in there like a bull. And back out it comes across to Nicky. Across it goes again, Saleh. And bursting through there is Alfred. Alfred's up to the 22. He's keeping going. He's got grand support there inside the 22. Fiji again onto the short side. Out to Ifirimi. Across it goes to Aisia. Aisia pulled down. He bounced the ball on the ground. And into touch it went. A bounce up down, he wasn't able to put the ball down into the touch, a dropout 22, said the referee. He was right there, and that's correct, a fair comment from the referee, who was a little distant as Fiji sped towards the corner flag. And a long kick there again, and I don't think it was judged terribly well by Western Samoa. Scooped up by Nicky Little inside his own half, flicks it towards the grandstand sideline. Sekovi, he hasn't got much support there. He manages to turn it over. Smith right up there once again. A good piece of effort in there and taking it away. Apelli playing halfback, gets it across to Tamanivalu. He goes down the grandstand sideline, feeds it back to nobody, and across there is Amori Katalau, and put his foot into touch on the grandstand sideline as he meets up with the busy Onehunga of Western Samoa. You wait again for the lineup to take place a meter inside Fiji's territory. Tala to put it in for Western Samoa as usual. The referee goes down to the back of the line to watch from the Western Samoa side as we wait for the throw in to come. Then it comes and up high, not taken tightly by anybody, knocked through. But the referee has said there was holding, and quickly taken by Western Samoa. They flick it back to Fadialofa. He's a little slow on his feet, and a forward pass to Fadialofa it was. Took it from in front, and he was gently dropped to the ground by Fiji. Rauluni to put it in again, five inside the Fiji's half. And it comes, and again, Dilemu shadowing Sekovi. Sekovi pushes the tackle off, back in field. Rouse unable to get it. Had his eyes closed, I guess, that time. He knocked it forward. Samoa have taken it into the ball and drive back. Towards the halfway line they come. They're making forward progress. Back out it goes to Fulemu. Sets a long one out there to Leo Pepe. He's caught inside the 10-meter line. Fiji's defense absolutely strong as Reedy works his way through, and now it comes onto the left, onto Serevi. Serevi throws a dummy, gives it across left, and there down the left goes, and back in field. And this time a burst away by Barry. Back in field it was, and a knock forward by Fiji. Barry could have done it alone. He decided to play it fair to the others. There were two outside him on his left, and as he threw the ball back, it was a knock forward by the support play of Fiji, and the Western Samoa line was wide open, a save for Western Samoa. Serevi and Bari showing tremendous combinations. Also in it was Luniau. Alfred was right up amongst them. We wait. I notice Rauluni limping his way around to the back of the scrum. Takes it onto the short side. And a tap kick from Samoa into touch on the 22-meter line on that terrace sideline. But the pressure exerted by the Fiji forwards and backs being almost unbearable to the Western Samoans. 33 points to nil. We've gone 6 minutes of the second half. No change in the halftime score. Though there might have been just that time. And it's Smith to throw it in. Ifirimi forward this time. Rouse behind him. Black near the back. Waiting for the throw from Smith. In it comes, and some good timing from Efraimi. He's got it at number four. And ball knocked to the ground, and now it comes to Tamanivalu. Tamanivalu bursts his way forward, pushes off a defender. He's still going, he's up towards the line. Nobody there to take it from him, though. Back it comes Roel Looney. He's pulled to the ground on the penalty against Samoa. Over the top went Winston Samoa as Roel Looney went to get that ball out. The referee had no hesitation and said, I'll have it. A wonderful piece of bullocking work from Tamanivalu. Probably the most successful that I've seen at any stage of Tamanivalu's effort in at the fringe of either the maul, line-out or ruck. Great piece of work from Tamanivalu, and they just showed a reluctance to tackle. It was an unusual reluctance. The Samoans are not normally like that, but Tamanivalu, with arm up in front of him, pushed the opposition away and made it look so easy. There it is, just like the penalty conversion, made to look so easy as Nicky logs up his fourth success from a penalty kick and takes Fiji's score on to 36 points to nil as we've gone 7 minutes into the second half. A Nicky penalty from in front, a very easy one. He steered it gently, just as Serevi does in Hong Kong, and extending the Fiji score. And there towards the grandstand sideline, my ball, says Roel Looney, inside his 22, straight back to Serevi, and Serevi, a very correct looking kick, beautifully placed, and bounces into touch right on the sideline, 1 metre inside Fiji's territory. It will be Talau to put it in, 1 metre inside. And we wait, in it comes, and Talau, taken nicely by Reedy near the front of the line for Western Samoa. He drives in there. They've got a very tight maul this time. And I notice there's somebody else who's come on for Western Samoa. I hadn't noticed a change in there. We've got Leo Falanico, who's on the field for Western Samoa. I hadn't even noticed him go on. As yes, come off was off the side as Stephen Smith has come off. I hadn't seen Smith come off. And so we see instead is Leo Falanico. He's actually gone into the lock position, which has effectively put Sene on the side for Western Samoa. And it goes, and the ball coming back, and a nice break. Felemu is able to weave his way through the defence. It's picked up again, though, by Nicky Little. Nicky trying to straighten it up. Didn't have a chance. Too much defence across there. Picked up again by Roel Looney. Ball lost to the ground. Across it goes towards the sideline. Brian Lima going down the side. Manasseh Mbari grabs him and pulls him to the ground. Ball loose. Western Samoa are caught. They're held to the ground. And head over heels went Black as he went to cut off the second effort from Western Samoa once Brian Lima was pulled to the ground by Manasseh Mbari. So the line-out to take place. Western Samoa right up against Fiji's line, 10 metres out, and are trying to organise their line-out while it's a Fiji throw-in. Fiji's throw-in, and this will be Greg Smith once again. Fiji's concerted effort, Katalau up near the front, and Katalau goes up, gets the touch, back it goes to Roel Looney, he's caught, he's in trouble, Smith takes the ball from him, and Smith backs his way into the opposition, and a Fiji put into the line, good defence from Fiji. Amazing how Serevi emerged with the ball out of that one, and Dan Rouse talking to Katalau and to Efraimi in there. And we've got yet another scrum to go down. Fiji on defence. Samoa, a chance on their attack. And back comes the ball through Fiji. Towards the back. And Roel Looney, wasting no time, clears it himself into touch, finding touch. Midway 22 and goal line. Samoa really applying the pressure now. The biggest effort that they've put in the 50 minutes the game's been in progress. Again, Lea Sata put the ball in for Western Samoa. In it comes, and a nice take near the front of the line there by Western Samoa. They've got it held in there. Fiji not giving an inch. Western Samoa trying to roll them all, and Fiji go through, but there is it's taken by Leo Fanolico. He's up to 12 metres out from the goal line. Ball lost to the ground. Samoa again. They've got a wide run from extra men out there. Knock forward, picked up by Nicky. Nicky's pulled it out of the air like that, taken into the ground. Fiji's advantage. Out it comes to Rolooney. He's got space he's found. And through the gap that goes and across to the grandstand sideline. Across to Tuilevu. Tuilevu gets it across over the open side. And to Ulu now out. And there goes Isaiah Tuilevu. Tuilevu up and gets it into the center field. And gets it back into Alfred. And Alfred goes round behind the post. And wonderful play, and the sensitivity of Western Samoa driving at the attack. Just had the ball passing, moving, and Western Samoa couldn't stem that drive. And Alfred has gone in. Alfred contributing a tremendous amount from the run inside the 22. It was started by Rolooney. Rolooney gathering, was looking for somebody to pass. And so did Samoa look to see who he was going to pass. A gap was open and the drive was on from inside the 22. And there were four of them all coming down like a wave and they go out of Lathalapai. And it's gone on to 43 points to nil with Alfred getting it and Nicky converting. And the score mounting in the 14th minute of the second half, and Alfred at the end of the line, where it was in and out, Alfred handling three times in the course of getting across to score. A magnificent score, that one. That's one out of the bag, one that's really worth writing a story about. Up nicely was Efraimi. Ball lost to the ground, picked up in there, however, by Western Samoa. Was knocked through by them. Knocked through by Senne, and we'll have the scrum to go down midway 22 and halfway with Fiji to put it in. Sakovi puts it in and it's healed, held there by Rouse. He's controlling it. And a flick behind to Nicky. Nicky gives it in there to Salih Sorabaki's, burst his way through. He comes back and runs into Leon Falanico. And the ball still going forward, though. Sokovi again, out to Sarevi. A chip kick angle towards the grandstand sideline, and down there goes Alfred again towards the grandstand sideline. A Western Samoa just not getting the ball and going forward. They're getting a little bit of, they're getting the crumbs as Fiji has always been used to, and Samoa making their own mistakes, many of them unforced. And so we have, into the line it goes, come back on Fiji's side. Efraimi braced himself as he took and tidied up. It's held in there by Fiji. Fiji driving in there and just taken off them by Samoa, but the referee had said it was Fiji's advantage. It must have been taken away as Efraimi had braced himself forward, and a good piece of sportsmanship from Fatty Alofa there as he lifts Efraimi from the ground, and they both go to their respective positions in the scrum. Sokovi puts it in. Ball bounced back into the scrum, and Sokovi gets it out to Nicky, and back, and Nicky doubles around. There's the same one again. Over the top it went, and forward past it went to Sarevi as that high ball over there just a little bit in front. And a difficult pass over the top from Sarevi. From Nicky to Sarevi it was. And forward it was. So it's a Western Samoa put in. 15 minutes gone in the second half. 43 points to nil. Fiji lead Western Samoa. Samoa with possession. Going over onto the short side. And a dash through there by Joe Filimu. He's left the ball behind. And Rouse turns around and sets up the counter-attack. They drive forward there. Five inside the Fiji half. Finding his way out was Rolooney, onto Nicky. Out in there was Isaiah Tuilevu. Lost the ball forward. Scrambled up by Western Samoa. And play carrying on. Tuivainga decides to straighten it up. And chip kicks into touch on the grandstand sideline. Good piece of work and support from Fire by Vine. Ball into touch on the grandstand sideline. Western Samoa never say die. And with even 17 minutes gone in the second half, they're still throwing everything into it. Fiji enjoying a big advantage of 43 points to nil. And it would look as if some attention required out there, is it? Manasambari is his leg playing up. No. It is closer to the base than it would appear to be Ferialofa, the referee, talking to Craig Smith. Little uncertain for the stoppage of play. Let's carry on, said the referee. Ferialofa is all right. Perhaps the pace of the game just a little bit hectic for the old man. Smith to put it in. Here it goes. Ephraimu was up high, but it was flicked away from him. And running through was halfback Philim, who was caught by Black. Down onto the ground, driving after Western Samoa after, but Raloni gets it away. And the penalty against Western Samoa. And Serevi quickly to take possession and drove it into touch, told his own forwards, get out of the way while I have a shot. And his long angled kick, finding touch 2 metres outside the 22 in Western Samoa territory. Fiji driving up on the attack, and now they start to reduce. Fiji reducing to a two-man line. Just two men in the lineup. Heading for it. And it comes and up, and there was a bump away there. And yes, there was a shoulder in there before ever there was contact. And the penalty to Fiji for obstruction in the lineout by the big man, Portu Liavasa. 10 metres outside the 22. And 14 in from the grandstand sideline. Another opportunity for Nicky Little. And that was the first of the reduced lines for Fiji. And how successful it has proven to be. Looked as if there was a little attention required in there for Mark Black, but he's all right. He's taking his position back there as Nicky Little lines it up. He's got wide open goalposts. 15 in from the grandstand sideline. And Nicky steered that one. No, it's outside. Not good enough, outside, over the dead ball line it is. A dropout 22, Samoa bringing it up very quickly. And you've got Terry Fonolua, who's also gone on for Western Samoa, out in the field of play now, taken by Serevi outside the 10 metres. Across it goes, and through goes Sukavi Raluni. He found the gap, and through he went. Ball left to be in behind, picked up in there by Black, but then left behind as Samoa, a hand on the ball in there, and Fiji giving it to Serevi. Serevi again angling towards the grandstand sideline, into touch, he made certain of it. It'll be a Fiji put into the line, a metre inside the 22. Points to nil it is. Fiji leading Western Samoa midway through the second half. Smith to put it in. It goes into the line up high, and a great take there by Fiji. Into the line it goes. And they storm in the inside. Tamani Valley goes forward. He's caught and pulled to the ground. Sokovi, there's Tamani Valley this time. Forward he goes once again. They're reluctant to take and tackle him. On it goes to Apelli. He pulled to the ground, but it was a forward pass. A piece of work from there, from a lovely line-out jump. And Tamani Valley driving forward, drilling his way into the opposition. Out it comes this time, Western Samoa, halfback Filimu onto Vai'ai, and they've got themselves into trouble. Filimu takes it again. They're lacking the support, they're forward, slow to get over. And there goes Fiji through, they go once again, back out it comes out of the open, and on it's gone this time, and an easy one, and this was Ifarimi's second try. Not a hand laid on him, as through he went, and scored. A very easy try, no real effort upon him, and Fiji extend their lead, 48 points to nil. A grand piece of work in there as they combined, and it was that, again I repeat, the knowledge they have of each other that enables them to be able to get through in the manner they did. Fine work from Fiji as we wait now for Nicky Little to see whether he can add the extra points to it. We wait for Nicky Little, whose try is close to the sideline. And in actual fact, the try was scored by Apelli. And Nicky's kick is away. So instead of Efraimi, who went over, it was Apelli who scored the next try. Apelli Naito Ivao. And he made it look so easy. And Fiji score mounts to 48 points to nil, 23 minutes into the second half. High ball towards the grandstand sideline, up high, and that was Efraimi taking that one. He gets good support, they surround him quickly. And back it comes to Sokovi, out to Nicky, and Nicky finds a gap there too, but there's three then that come in onto him from three different angles. Haul him to the ground, out comes Tamani Valu. He dives to the ground and turns over, setting it up nicely. Oh, and brilliantly picked up by Serevi. Back in field is Sokovi. Sokovi to Serevi. Serevi leaves the ball on the ground. Going in and grabbing it was on the open side, I see her. He goes down towards the 22. Fiji forwards right up there, fearlessly continuing to drive forward. Back out it comes, out to Serevi. And pins in the background, back line. The Samoans a mile offside. And out it goes quickly across onto the left and onto the right. And here's Bowie playing for a corner. Bumps him up for the try. The try is awarded. A brilliant piece of work with Manassim Bowie. He's absolutely ecstatic about that effort. Manasseh gets it. It's really his first effort, but it was the determination that made it possible for Manasseh when that ball was flicked out to him. Not a lot of room to move in, but the Tavua speedster made the most of it, and in the 25th minute, it was Manasseh's try, and he bumped off the only man who attempted, and the defender went straight to ground. Manasseh over for a dive, and talk about a toothy smile. That was Manasseh's thrill to have been able to contribute. 53 points to nil, Fiji leading Samoa with still now 16 minutes to go. The kick is outside, it's short of the mark, but it remains at 53 points to nil. So we wait for the restart of play as Western Samoa come up and Fiji forwards scatter across the whole width of ground on both sides. And it sounds as if there's somebody in the grandstand with a whistle in his mouth. There's the long one. Massino. It's a long kick. And the ball doesn't bounce back over the goal line as might have been thought, and it's thrust out instead to Serevi. And Serevi just takes from finger to toe, just like a ballet dancer would do. Just down it went, flop, and then away into touch on the grandstand sideline. Into touch, 9 metres inside his own half. It was, again, part of the combination, part of the knowing play, part of the players being so familiar with each other. And the fact that the squad, I'm sure, is the one that's been kept together. In it goes, and back to Western Samoa. Out it goes across to, it'll miss out past the two of Vahinga. He decides to lift it into the air. A crop coming after it is Isaiah Tuilevu. He didn't take it, Serevi took it instead. Flicks it away across the grandstand sideline. Isaiah Tuilevu, a high ball, straight back then, taken nicely by. He puts it back. And there's a kicking duel on. My ball back here, says Apelli. He takes it and feeds it back nicely to Nicky. Nicky then, unhesitatingly, slams it into touch on the grandstand sideline. Midway, 22 and halfway on this grandstand side of the field. 53 points to nil. Play with now 14 minutes left to play. Western Samoa forwards a little ragged up there now as halfback Philemu talks to them and Talaasa to throw it in. It comes, and a nice take, an easy take that time by Ephraim. He gives it on to Joelli. Joelli manages to get his way through. Onahunga, a nice drive off him by Amori. Ball left behind, flicked up again, given wide. Ifirimi lost the ball to the... Not Ifirimi, it was Tamanivalu who lost the ball to the ground. Picked up in there neatly by Reddy. He's got it and held in there. Back out comes Western Samoa. They're getting it out wide. A long kick across, angled towards the touchline. And the ball runs away into touch with a number of the Samoans on the ground, not the least of whom is Sene, who is obviously had a problem with his chest. He's on his feet and away he goes to as physiotherapy assistance was reaching him. So Western Samoa driving inside the Fiji's 22-metre line, 2 metres inside the 22. Smith to put it into the line. A blemish that let the ball away that time from Fiji's point of view. And this is the telling time. The last 12 minutes of the game. Remember the last time we spoke in South Africa, it was Fiji toe-to-toe with the Springboks and it was the last 20 minutes that told. And here we have Western Samoa starting to drive. They haven't got a point on the board at this moment, 10 metres inside the 22. Western Samoa showing some control amongst the forwards. A second breath of wind, as it were, and out it comes onto the open side to Vaivai. Out right again to the replacement, Fanua. Down it comes, and Western Samoa taking it onto the short side. Wide they go once again. Across it goes onto the wing, and there's Onahunga right across there. A flick pass across there. Smith across with Manasambari, running it into touch, 12 metres from the corner flag, in front of the huge crowd gathered still over there, despite a few deciding they've seen all they need. Western Samoa again to put it in. 11 minutes left in the game. Fiji 53, Western Samoa 0. In it comes, and a good jump in there by Portu. But Fiji have got it. Back it comes to Rauluni, and a hand right through there, offside. The penalty against Western Samoa. So Revy takes it without hesitation. No delay. And the ball into touch, midway 22 and halfway. Wait for the next line out to take place. Smith to put it in for Fiji. We wait for the line out to commence. And up was Ephraimi, but the ball goes right down to Black. He didn't get it. Yes, he did. He got it, and he's taken to the ground, though. Turned over, and they've got him blocked from being able to let the ball out. And the penalty against the Western Samoas for doing so. Smith was going to take it, but feeds it up to Serevi. And Serevi puts another huge kick in. Deep into Western Samoa territory it goes. 9 metres outside the 22 on that terrace side of the field. Fiji forwards it themselves. A little slow to get up this time. With 10 minutes to go, Fiji ahead 53 points to nil. Waiting for the line-out to take place. In it comes. Up high, Western Samoa. Ball lost loose and flicked into the open. A long one, a miss-out pass down to Saleh. Saleh puts one wide and gives it through there to Manasa. Manasa puts a chip on and takes it. Manasa up after it. Manasa takes it. And Manasa gets the ball. He raced through there. Manasa Bari again. And Manasa had taken it. He was fed brilliantly in the middle. And as he had a little, he had two in front of him. He hesitated what he was going to do. It was two to have on, he couldn't have it. He decided the chip over the top was the way to go. And he raced after it. He scurried after it, to say it truly, and was able to gather a very short dead ball line. But he was able to get the bouncing ball and dive at the same time, taking it on to 58 points to nil. They gone now. 31 minutes of the second half. 31 minutes gone. Fiji leading by 58 to nil. Now to 60 points to nil. 60, Nicky's next try, next conversion. Manasa's second try. 60 points to nil, I can't remember, in favour of Fiji. Particularly in such what was considered to be a crucial match, a crucial encounter against the ever so improved Western Samoa side. There was a more standard kick that time. Western Samoa can't handle the ball, eventually got it out from Falemu, goes wide, gives it on to replacement Fanalua. He's caught and taken to the ground in midway 22 and halfway. Good tackle on him by Tamani Valu. And out it comes again, Western Samoa having a plug on the grandstand sideline. Not much space to go, and across it comes in, and taken down there, Alex Talia, and a good tackle upon him. Two of them there, I see it to Elevu, and Nicky Little, both there. Good support in there as well by Saleh Zoravaki. They're all there in defence. We wait again for the line-out to take place. 7 metres inside the 22, grandstand side of the field. We wait for the Samoan throw-in. Wing goes across for Samoa to join outside Brian Lima. Into the line and bad, a tap back, a difficult one. Knocked through by Onehunga as he picked it up again. Tried to bound his way through, but the referee said no, it was knocked on first. It kindly bounced up to him and he got it, but we'll take it again. Sokovi to put it in on defence for Fiji. Saleh Zoravaki coming in to make it easier. And Sokovi himself decides to kick for the line and finds it into touch on the grandstand sideline. And another replacement for Samoa warming up on the grandstand sideline. Kaisa Tuingamala is warming up on the grandstand sideline. Wonder whom he will replace as Fiji. Tuingamala, it looks like Brian Lima coming off. It is Lima limping his way from the field, and we have it's Tala to throw it in for Western Samoa. They've just about gone through all their reserves now, Western Samoa. In it comes, they've got the tap back. Mightn't have been terribly straight, but referees let him go, and Tuingamala gets the first touch of his ball just inside the Fiji half, and back it comes. No, it was tapped back by Western Samoa then. Out it comes from Onehunga. Onehunga works his way forward, then loses the ball to the ground, kicks it through. Picked up a back in here, brilliantly done, and was taken by Alfred, and as he goes to the ground, a handle ball, said the referee, and quickly taken by Western Samoa, out onto the open side, infield goes Seni. He's taken to the ground, he's on his own, rest of his forwards slow to get across, they managed to tap it back somehow, a misunderstanding again amongst the Samoans, and the knock forward brings back a scrum, the scrum to go down 8 metres outside Fiji's 22, and the edge tending to go off the game, and mistakes coming in as the players are showing signs of fatigue as a result of a spectacularly fast game. Back it comes towards Rolooney, picked up off the back there by Rouse. He's worked his way through, he hasn't got the legs, gets it onto Rolooney, a bad pass to Rolooney, a man in a worse position than Rouse was, and the penalty against Fiji. Quickly taken by Pat Lamb. Gets it across then to Famasino. He's caught and then where's it come? Taken in there by the forwards. Neatly in by the Samoan forwards. They start to roll it. Fiji taking it a little easy for the moment. And then Western Samoa have got it in control nicely from Seni. And out it comes wide. Bad. Across it goes, however. Gathering it is Vaivai. Taken away from him. He's taken the thrust to the ground. His forwards again slow to get across there. Fiji's forwards pour in over the top, but Samoa have got it. Out it comes wide. Smith's cut him off. Across it goes to Vainga. Vainga continues to go through. He's managed to get himself through a gap and failed to pass. Lost the advantage. Ball gone to the ground, and the penalty against Fiji. Western Samoa coming in strong, 4 minutes to go. A quick tap taken, and towards the line they go again. Ball lost to the ground, flicked back to Fiji. Joali flicks it away and gives it across out there to Ului Nayao. Given across onto the left, and then Manasa Mbari. And Manasa coming back in field, ran into trouble, across it to Alfred. Alfred loses it. Onehunga takes it from him. A wrestle is on as they're taken to the ground, five inside the 22. Samoa disorganised, Fiji in disarray for the moment, but tackled into the ground Western Samoa while they're making no forward progress. Back it comes towards Western Samoa, Reedy with it, decided he was playing half-back and then ran with it. He's taken to the ground, ball left behind, Samoa again, ball knocked out of the hands, and once again, ball lost by Western Samoa, flicked out into the open. They're all standing flat-footed, out there is to Uvayinga, and Fiji offside, said the referee, a metre inside the 22. Samoa are going to take it a quick one. They do make it quick. On to Faliemu. A chip-up kick over the top. And the ball not touched. An interesting decision comes here. It was kicked from about 8 metres inside Fiji's 22. The ball bounced over the goal line. The referee described the change in rule now and where it had gone over the dead ball line. The referee said it can be Fiji with the option of a 22 or a scrum from where that ball was kicked. And there's the application of the law that has just come into force. In from Sikovi. Rolooney trying to position himself. Manages to flick it away to Sarevi, and Sarevi puts it back into the terrace side of the field. The ball runs away like a rat did, and out it was.
5 minutes.
Some 13 metres inside Fiji's territory. For a Western Samoa put in. And it looks as if Alfred might be getting a little bit of attention. There is a tap back for Fiji. Rolooney had trouble getting rid of it, but Bari comes along in support. Inside his 22, Bari puts a long angle kick, and it bounds into touch. A metre outside Fiji's half on the grandstand sideline, and we've still got 3 minutes to go in the game. Fiji continue their lead, 60 points to nil over neighbours Western Samoa. And I notice that Alfred is getting that attention back out there. Sarevi asks for the game to be held up. The referee's carrying on. As I see it, Tuilevu is looking to join. Alfred goes on to his feet, and Sarevi is right back there. In it comes, and a tap back there by Western Samoa is picked up by Black. Knocked forward as he went together, though. And the scrum to go down, 8 metres inside Western Samoa's territory. And 15 in from the grandstand sideline. 2 minutes left in the game. In it goes. Western Samoa get it away. They're using their back line out to Uvayinga, and again he dodges his way around, but caught in there by Ifarimi. Held up midway 22 and halfway. A pile in amongst the forwards, and out it comes to Western Samoa again. And a kick towards the grandstand sideline. Ball out on the full, and back we come. A forgetful kick from Vaivai, and we come back to 12 metres inside Western Samoa's territory. 1 minute to go, Fiji ahead, 60 points to nil, and a token gesture to the Fiji side that very few people have left the ground. The ground's still packed at this hour of the day, at this stage of the game. Rarely do we see so few people leaving. Smith to put it in. In it goes, and a nice touch, and taken at the back there by Tamanivalu. He couldn't get his pass away, but ball set up nevertheless. Rolooney's got it. Flicks it away to... No, he changes his mind and gives it out onto the open. Rouse has found it his way through, gets it away onto the open, and ball left to the ground. Knocked forward, though, as it was a lost effort from Rouse, playing a mighty game for Fiji. Also limping, as I see, as he goes back into his position, but he was unable to link up with Amori Katalau that time. If Katalau had got it, he'd have bounded right out of sight. In it comes, and picked up nicely off the back there by Pat Lamb, trying to play it on his own. He hasn't got the support of his forwards. Eventually it's flicked up and ball lost to the ground. Picked up again by Faliemu. Faliemu takes it forward and then flicks it away. Picked up neatly back in there by Falonico. He's up towards the 10-metre line and taken to the ground, and picked up easily in there by Seni. Moves it out wide. Dodging in and out is to Uvayinga. He's pulled down to the ground, and they decided to make it onto the grandstand side of the field. And pull back for Messino. Runs into trouble as he slips to the ground. Smith greeted him with pleasure. And back out it comes. Pat Lamb gets it away to... It was out that time to Tungamala. The referee said it was no advantage to Fiji. They take the scrum, he said. And with time showing on my clock, there's little likelihood of the game going for much longer. 60 points to nil. Fiji continue to lead Western Samoa. And the incredible factor of it is that Fiji's line not crossed. Here it comes, and out onto the right flank, neatly done onto Serevi. He jinked his way through, a thrust back in field after his friend Manassam Bari couldn't link it through. Western Samoa instead, right up and after it was Rouse. He couldn't get through either, and out it comes this time onto Onohanga, who's been playing a great game for Samoa. He's caught as he tried to go through on his own. The rest of the Samoan forwards pour in over the top. Out it comes, a neat piece of work from Samoa. Replacements are on in a plenty, and they're trying to go through on their own. Back it comes once again. Samoa linking it up nicely. Gives on to Falaniku that time. Out it comes once again. Samoa continuing their drive forward. Fiji tending to be left behind. Joely standing up watching what's happening. Goes back behind the line and out wide it goes. Samoa are 3-on-2 and they try to step inside. They're caught in possession though and they can't get anywhere as Talia took the wrong option. Back it comes Samoa again. Out on towards the grandstand side it comes. In the back line and across towards this Onohanga again. And he ran like a bat for the moment but pulled into touch. And Uluneau has brought it into touch. And there is Fiji has defeated Western Samoa by the biggest score that I can remember in the Pacific Three Nations Tournament. Fiji against what I would call the favourites for the tournament, Western Samoa. Their experience not good enough. The rising stars of the Pacific coming back in strength and going from 33 points to nil at halftime, taking victory in the end by 60 points to nil. They continued in the second half where they left off in the first half and logged up additional tries, 1, 2, 3, 4 of them in the second half, several of them converted, and a wondrous effort from Fiji with the crowd ecstatic at the performance of the side. The home team absolutely showered by the children around the place. They want to get in to offer congratulations to their own team and are completely surrounding, and with the rush made from the grandstand sideline, the rush of kids now comes from all